Hey you guys, so it's really late and I'm kind of tired, but I really wanted to make this video. It's the second topic on Team or Young Moms Unite, and it is about support and living conditions. So to start off, I have an awesome support system. I have my whole family, I have a lot of friends. My true friends have stuck by me through the whole thing, through my whole pregnancy and to now. And I'm really blessed and I'm lucky that I have all those people to love McKenna and be there for her and would do anything for her and me. So when I found out I was pregnant, I told my mom, and my mom pretty much knew from the second I started getting like flu-like symptoms. She kind of knew that something was going on other than me just being sick, because before I knew I was pregnant, I was home and I thought I had the flu, and I didn't go to school. I stayed home for about 4 days, and I didn't understand why I felt so sick. So, I looked at my mom one day while she was vacuuming. I go, "Mom, I need to tell you something, but I'm scared." And she looks at me and she goes, "You think you're pregnant, don't you?" And I go, "Yeah." And then I go, "How do you know?" And she goes, she just says, "Just by the way you're acting and just, I guess, motherly instincts." Like, she knew. So she went out and got me a pregnancy test, and then of course I took 3 tests, and of course every single one of them said I was pregnant. So I told her. I waited a few days, and then I told the dad. And the first thing is I went to Planned Parenthood to get an abortion. And I am what is it called? I'm pro-choice, so, or pro-life, whatever you call it. I don't know. It's the one where you can choose, and I'm not going to, say that you're a terrible person for choosing that, but everybody has a reason, and I don't feel like we should bash them and say they're a murderer and everything, because everybody has a story. So I went to Planned Parenthood. My mom went with me, and the baby's dad went with me, and I went in. I got the test, and they told me I was about 7.5 weeks pregnant. So I was in the room, and well, first off, they told me I was that many weeks pregnant, and then they sent me to a room, and they showed me what a DNC looked like. It was a video of what they do and how they suction everything out. So after that, I went into a room. And I go in the room, and I sit down, and the lady starts talking to me. I'm like, "I need my mom in here." So my mom comes in, and she starts talking to me. She starts showing me pictures of the ultrasound. And she looks at me, and she goes, "The baby doesn't even have a heartbeat. The baby doesn't have fingers. The baby doesn't have toes. It's the size of a less than a pea." So I told her that I can't make a decision right now. I need to go home. I need to think. And my mom was kind of pushing me to do it at first. She was scared, and she was scared that I was going to be ruining my life. So I went home, and I thought about it, and then I went on the internet, and I wanted to see what a 7.5, 8-week-old baby looked like. So I looked it up and I saw that the baby had fingers, the baby had toes, the baby had a heartbeat. The baby had everything that that lady said didn't. And at first, if I was maybe 4 or 5 weeks pregnant, I would have gotten the pill and I would have ended the pregnancy. But when they told me that I would have to get a DNC, I think that's, I'm pretty sure that was, that's what it's called. I'm sorry if I didn't say the right word, but when they showed me that, I just couldn't do it. So I sat down with my mom one day and I told her that I couldn't kill something inside me. I couldn't I felt like a murderer. That's what I felt like. And this was my baby, and I didn't want to kill her. And so I told her, and she's like, okay, we can do this. I'll help you as much as I can along the way. So the next thing I did was I called my dad, and first thing my dad said was, you cannot kill my grandchild. You cannot get rid of my grandchild. We can do this. All I want you to do is graduate and get through high school, and I'll support you all the way. So pretty much everybody in my family supported me, and I'm very lucky. And my mom has helped me so much and has given me so much. And I'm so grateful for everything I have. And now I'm here. And my living situation is, I lived with my mom for a little bit. Then I moved into my grandma's. Then I moved into my dad's. And now we're at our own place. And we're happy and healthy and love it here and have our own space, and we can do whatever we want. We can make a mess and nobody will tell us to clean it up, and she can throw her toys all over the place and have fun and go upstairs in her bedroom and play, and I don't have to worry about her getting into things. And she, it's her home, it's our home. And we're really excited, and we've come a long way, and I'm really lucky for everything I've been given. So yeah, I think that's it. So, if you guys have any questions, just leave it in the comments below, or you can even, private message me if you have any questions. So yeah, thanks guys. Bye.